Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi student, you're back to science class with me, Miss Nur Nur Asia. Our topic today is still about human skeleton. In the last meeting, you have learned about the name of parts of human skeleton, right? And today we still are going to talk about the same topic. Okay? And our learning goals today are, first one, you can distinguish the strength of long bones and short bone. And in the second, you can describe the differences and similarities of human skeleton with one of animal skeleton. Okay, student. Now I want to demonstrate the strength of a bone. In this demonstration, we use drinking straw to replace real bones. And we are going to use the force meter to measure the force needed to bend the straw. This is drinking straw. And this is force meter. Okay, in your opinion, which straw is stronger, long straw or short straw? Miss Muna, please help me. Okay, thank you, Miss Muna. Okay, student. Here, Miss Nurnur will check how many force needed to bend a straw. I have two straw, first one a long straw and short straw. Which straw is stronger, long straw or short straw? Okay, we will check first one for long straw. Okay, look at here. We need 3 newton to bend long straw. How about short straw? Okay, we'll check. Whoa! To bend short straw, we need more 3 newton. Okay? So short straw are stronger than long straw. That means long bones are easier to break than short bone. Thank you. Thank you, Miss Muna. Okay, student, let's do exercise 1 and 2 in your worksheet, and please read the instruction first. Okay, student, please open your worksheet first and look into the picture human skeleton and heart skeleton. In the last meeting, you have learned about all of part of human skeleton, and now please compare and observe between the horse and human skeleton. Look at carefully and do exercise 1. Okay, student. Please open your worksheet and do exercise 1. Look at to the horse picture. Okay, here you should understand about all of part of horse skeleton, and I think you have understand about all of part of human skeleton, right? So now please let's check
the horse skeleton and please answer the questions by yes or no. For example, does it have skull? If the answer yes, please checklist yes. If horse don't have skull, you did the answer no. Okay. For example, does it have spine cord? Does it have scapula? Does it have sternum and rib and so on? After that, please answer what are the similarities between horse skeleton and human skeleton? Is there are differences between them? And give the conclusion. Okay, student, just to reminding, I think you have understand too about human skeleton. And please compare and observe between the snake and human skeleton picture. Okay, look at and observe carefully all of parts. Okay, student, look at carefully to the snake picture and please compare between snake skeleton and human skeleton. So for exercise 2, please observe part of snake skeleton and answer the question yes or no. Give you questions yes if snake have the part of the body. Does it have skull? Does snake have a skull? If the answer yes, please keep yes. And does it have spine cord? Does it have scapula? And so on. And please ensure what are the similarities between snake skeleton and human skeleton? Are there a differences between them? And give the conclusion. Okay, student, please read again carefully your worksheet until you more understand. And let's do exercise 1 and 2 in your worksheet.
Okay, student, I think that's all. And please submit your assignment in Google Classroom or in WhatsApp group. I will see you again in the next week. Thank you.